Hi, I'm Rukmal, and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Ren. We've been working on something really special that I'm excited to share with you today. Since the invention of general-purpose computing, it has been the dream of computer scientists to invent a machine that can learn from new experiences. So far, deep learning has been the vehicle to realize this dream. Starting in the 1950s with the invention of the perceptron, decades of research and development and standing on the shoulders of giants led to the introduction of the transformer, the underlying architecture that powers many of the deep learning advances we see in the world today. From computers that you can chat with to cars that can drive themselves, deep learning has enabled diverse applications. While impressive, these achievements have been enabled by scale and have thus come at great cost. Starting in 2012, AlexNet kicked off an explosion of scale. This continued through the 2010s, enabling deep learning systems to blast through milestones, like beating the game of Go and modeling human language. Since then, capital investments have continued to grow and are now at 11-figure sums, with increasingly diminishing returns. Despite this, it's still unclear how deep learning systems will enable the next generation of intelligent computing experiences that stretch the imagination. Ren was founded 2 years ago to address this challenge. We set out to design a new kind of machine, a machine that replicates the predictions of deep learning, a machine that can learn from new experiences, and a machine that can do all of this as efficiently as the human brain. It's called the Universal State Machine. The Universal State Machine is built on entirely new computing principles, designed from the ground up for intelligence. It uses a dual representation system to encode and store information and novel physics-based algorithms for training and inference. We believe the Universal State Machine represents the best foundation for delivering on the promise of artificial intelligence. Now, I'm excited to showcase an early stage prototype of a universal state machine as it grows dynamically and learns from new experiences. In this demonstration, we're going to be using the Tiny Stories dataset, which is a dataset of bedtime stories written by GPT-4. It's commonly used to benchmark small language models, right? And this dataset effectively looks like very simple bedtime stories that you would read to a two-year-old. So these are some examples of what the data is that we will be training on. Second, we're going to be using the Universal State Machine, or USM as we like to abbreviate it, the CLI for that, which exposes functionality over USM machines, everything from compiling, what we call loading in data, calibration, what we call training, to synthesis, what we call inference. You can see this working over here. So what I'm going to do to start out is I'm going to create a new USM database, which is the backing store for the data that goes into a universal state machine. So I'm just going to do USM database create. We're going to call it stories.db. We can see that was initialized successfully. Third, the USM uses a system of states, specifically a system of symbolic states, right? And the way to think about this is that states of the USM are like what tokens will be to a deep learning model. So in this case, for example, the phrase once upon will be broken up into the states once and upon. Next, what we're going to be looking at in the demo as we go through this is we're going to be growing a universal state machine, right? So we're going to show it learning from new experiences in the form of data and the underlying graph structure that powers the USM growing dynamically. This is in stark contrast to how LLMs work, where the model size is defined as a hyperparameter before you start out any training on the model itself, right? So we're going to be seeing it growing the USM model, and the number of stories that we're going to use to grow this width is going to be in tranches. So we're going to start with 40 stories, then we're going to go up to add another 100 for a total of 140. Before finally adding another 860 stories for a total of 1,000. Finally, we're going to be testing the performance and looking at how the USM outputs data for the seed prompt once, as in once upon a time. Perfect. Now, the demo itself uses a build script which calls into the USM CLI, and we can see that over here. Right, so it calls the commands to load in new data, to calibrate the data, and then to finally perform synthesis on each of the models as we run through them one by one. Now, just to confirm, the model that we're using currently has zero nodes in it, zero connections. And what we're going to do is we're just going to start out by running the build script. So like I mentioned, we're going to start with 40. And now again, what you're going to see is the model loading in data, calibrating, and then performing inference on that data with the seed prompt of once. Cool. Now you can see here with a test data set of 40 stories, the output is mostly gobbledygook, and that's to be expected. Right, and just to confirm over here, we can see that the size of the graph actually increased to 17,000 total nodes with a total connection count of about 50,000. Furthermore, because this is an interpretable data structure, we can actually go in and query it. So we can actually go in and see, hey, what does this graph data structure look like around a symbol that we're interested in? In this case, it's the word once. Next, we're going to load in another 100 stories, bring up the total to 140. See Voyager running and inference already done. Now, you can see the structure improving significantly in this case, right? And additionally, you can also see a couple of pretty interesting things. So right here, where it says a little named, you can see that the model has already learned structurally from the data that it's seen that a good additional possible word that could go in here would be the word girl, but also the word boy. Correspondingly, for each of these, it's also identified two names, right? A male name and a female name corresponding to each of those. And you'll see how the performance on this and the resolution of the model improves as we load in more and more data. Now, just to confirm one more time, we can see that the model size itself has grown. Again, with an LLM, you predefine the size of the model, and then you train it to saturation. The USM dynamically creates a model that's the perfect size for the data that you're loading into it. And we can look over here and actually see that the graph structure itself has grown. You can see that the complexity of these geometries enhances considerably with additional data. Now, finally, we're gonna load in another 860 stories. Now, I'd also like to point out that the Voyager optimization you see running here is running entirely on my laptop, right? We're not connected to a server, it's running on general purpose CPU hardware. There's no GPU on this machine. And you can see here that it's doing an energy simulation for Electron and printing out the results. And wow, we can see a pretty big improvement here compared to the previous iteration. And like I was alluding to earlier, it's correctly identified structurally similarities between things like genders and names for people in each of those genders, right? And we can see here, she loved to play outside in the, but in the location of outside, you can also see she loved to play with, she loved to play in. And these are also valid completions that we see improving as the amount of data that's loaded into the system increases. Now, finally, we can go back and look at the total node count and see why we've grown to 176,490 now with 500,000 connections. And finally, we can see the complex geometry that's created by that new graph in the USM console. That looks awesome. You can actually emit messages to simulate the message passing functionality in the USM at inference and training time. To recap, what you just saw was the first ever public demonstration of the revolutionary universal state machine technology. You saw the Lattice compiler dynamically grow USM systems with new data. The Voyager calibration system used to train these systems incredibly efficiently. And finally, the electron synthesis algorithm to perform generation at speeds not possible with LLMs. These components can be orchestrated together to enable a new kind of real-time intelligence application not possible with deep learning technology. To compare, we trained a deep learning LLM using the GPT-1 architecture on the exact same data you just saw the USM operate on. As you can see, it takes considerably longer for the LLM to train and perform inference. Further, we see that the fidelity of the generations from the LLM to the comparable USM match up with almost perfect alignment. The efficiency of the underlying USM algorithms will deliver performance gains that continue to compound with scale. The story of computing is a story of democratization, a progression of what was once available to the few being made available to the many. We've already seen this story with general purpose computing systems, centralized at its conception, and then decentralized with the personal computer. For intelligent computing, Ren will enable this progression to decentralization with the universal state machine. Our first USM-enabled product will be available later this year. We can't wait to see what you'll build with this technology. You can learn more by visiting our website or reading our white paper. Thanks for watching.